Hey guys, Cludd here. Man, it's been a long time, YouTube. It's been a long time. lots changed in my life, so that's why I haven't been able to record a YouTube video in a really long time. So I'm happy that I'm finally been able to start recording again and kind of picked up the interest again. So this is gonna be one of the first games that I'm gonna be start playing. I love this game so much, and it's just a lot of fun. I know there's Dark Souls 3 is out, and it looks like it'll be really good. One of the reasons why, one of the things is that I didn't get all of the Dark Souls, actually. I only got Dark Souls 1. I was very hesitant about Dark Souls 2, and then after I saw Dark Souls 2, all the reviews coming out, I was like, oh yeah, I'm gonna stay away from this game. It just doesn't seem like it's my cup of tea. But Dark Souls 3 looks really good. It looks like a game that I would have a lot of fun in, and hopefully I'll be able to get that sometime soon. But for now, we're going to go ahead and keep with the good old, Dark Souls 1. So a couple of other things I should let you guys know. I have never beaten Dark Souls. Now, some of you guys are saying, what? And yeah, I have. It's been out for a long time. I love playing this game, but I've never beaten it's just two things happened to me, and it almost happened to me in Skyrim, where I almost didn't do all the different main quests. And that's, I love creating new characters and finding new ways to fight and do battle. And that's my biggest issue with RPGs, is that I never seem to be able to actually finish a game.
In the age of ancients.
I'm gonna skip this because I'm sure all of you who are watching this have seen that cutscene about 50 million times. Oh boy. I wonder if you guys can see this in the video. I have horrible friend. There we go. Air kicked in. Good job there, old boy. Man, the frame rate right there in that hallway was horrible. I haven't recorded videos in a long time, so I forgot all my different settings, and so it's gonna be a learning experience again for all of us. So yeah, so I haven't ever beat Dark Souls 1. I've gotten real close. Well, I think it's close. I've gotten to Seath, Scalus. That was the last boss that I beat. I couldn't figure out for life of me where to fight the next boss. I went to the Drowned City, and I was just like, man, where do I go to fight people? I have no idea where to fight the boss here. And I had no idea where else to go, and so I was like, you know what? I'm gonna start a new game. Instead of figuring out where the la this next box is, or the last boss was. But yeah, no, I haven't fought the Four Kings, and haven't gotten through that. I'll tell you one thing, getting through Ornstein and Smough, I've only been able to do that once with that one character. Otherwise, all the other characters I've made, never been able to beat Ornstein and Smough. That is just one heck of a fight. So, we'll see if I can do it in this game. So, I actually didn't pick one of my favorite to start off with, which used to be the deprived.
I wish to you regrettably.
I love the Deprive just because of his starting weapon, the club. And I know you can get the Cludd. You can get the club at the merchant. I know. But I also really like that he had so many stats, soul level, and all these different stats. I love that diversity. But we're gonna try it out with the knight and see where it goes. Done this part of the game so many times, it's ridiculous. I probably done this about a million times and I'll still get that. I'm not over-exaggerating either. I probably did do a million times, just because I've created so many characters and just deleted them all the time. Okay. Let's kill the Asylum Demon, shall we? Every time I beat this guy, I never remember which door it is. So I haven't been able to do much of any recording. I think the last time I recorded was like, 2 years ago? 3 years ago? Boy, man, I'll tell you one thing. 2 or 3 years ago seems like a lifetime ago. I mean, everything has changed.
Only in the ancient legends it is stated that one day an undead shall be chosen.
Ha-ha! Also, the really weird thing is how they actually switched things in this game. Like, right now this is 3 humanity. A long time ago, it used to be, a soul of a lost undead? Something like that. Now it's 3 humanity. I don't use humanity really. I guess I use it for ammo.
Hello there, I am, if not. Hello, I am here. No.
Come on, give me your miracles.
I have so wood. Very well. Now, let me share only. Come again. Be effective.
I don't know if I actually want to heal miracles, just because it's like, no, it's nice, but your Estus flasks get really powerful, so I'm not sure if it's really necessary. Well, Although it is really nice to, you know, just use that and not have to worry about your Estus. So, I'll try not to use this video too much to go on about tangents about what I'm hopefully going to be trying to do, but I will actually say, tell you a couple of games I'm looking at maybe doing, which I'm actually excited to do a couple playthroughs, like, of Darkest Dungeon. Reason why I haven't done a playthrough of that, just not recording it, is because it never seemed quite finished, which it wasn't a finished game, and I don't know if it's finished yet, but I think it's at a stage or at a point where I'm happy with it. When I was first playing the game, I liked it. It's just it seemed like it was missing some things, and you know, it's real interesting how they changed some aspects of it too. Some things I don't like about Darkest Dungeon that they've changed, and some things I do. So, anyways, enough of Darkest Dungeon. I really shouldn't have done that with 2,000 souls. Jeez. Let's see if I can get the straight sword of story, and I didn't make a big mistake. I think it's 12 faith, but we will see. So with this build, this is going to be kind of a faith build. I'm going to be using faith weapons and occult weapons, as well as a couple of miracles. I'm not gonna really use too much of the Way of Light miracles. I haven't really done too much with miracles, actually. I like the Restore Straight Sword. I like straight swords in this game. They're really nice. I love their moveset, and I do know that the Restore Straight Sword actually is worse than the longsword once you get the longsword to like what, +3, +5? I think it's +3. The longsword beats the Astora Straight Sword. But don't quote me. I'm not that much of a Dark Souls nerd. I use the term nerd with great affection. I love getting better at this game. I love playing it too. And I'm not very good at this game. But I'm not too shabby. This guy's pretty tall. Okay. Oh. I thought I could arrange it, but I got the sword, and then one more death roll. Firekeeper soul. I usually do this on most playthroughs. I don't do this on every playthrough, but on most, I usually have the master key and then go down here and do this, and I'm sure everyone does this too, or most people. first time I ever played this game, I played... I think I played either as the Knight or the Wanderer. And I picked the... Charm. Because I thought I was going to do something cool. And I was looking all over the place for it to do something cool. I never really did anything cool, really. I guess the Witch's Ring is pretty cool. Because then you can talk to Quaaline. Able to do both the dragon and the drowned city kind of thing for the Firekeeper's soul and not die. I've only been able to do that once. Alright. She cannot speak. I think we'll probably give her the ability to speak in this playthrough. What is it? 14. Alright. I knew I was making a mistake. I felt like it. I didn't know it, but it felt like it. Souls for animals other than to be used. Let's see how many I need. Wow, that's a lot of levels. Awesome. Now we can begin our adventure forward. Oh yeah. Oh, I love this one. Just one shots. Also, this is a really good shield. I'll ever use another shield just because of how good this one is. Oh, my draw wasn't quick enough. Wait a second. Did I grab that one treasure? I did. So. So, I'll be looking in the comments, but if anyone knows how to fight the four kings, when I get to that point, great. There it is. I don't know, I can look it up, but I don't really like looking up little facts like that. I like trying to discover it for myself. Alright, let's just escalate that entire conversation. a little cluddy right now. Guys are so annoying. Come back. Man, I love this sword. This is why I pick it up at the start when I play the knight all the time. Otherwise, if I'm not playing a knight or the cleric, then I usually get the Drake sword. But I much prefer the Astoris Drake sword, just because it has the same moveset as all these other straight swords, which, in my opinion, is one of the most versatile kind of movesets in the entire game. I don't think there's any moveset that is as versatile as the straight sword. You got your sweeping attacks, you got your vertical slashes, you got your thrusts. It's great. Jump for it! Okay, Captain Price. There you go. I missed that jump quite a few times. Another question is, does that merchant have anything that I want? Does he have anything that I really want? I don't think he does. I'm not gonna get the Drake sword with this playthrough. It's because I have the Astoris Drake sword, so I don't really need another starting weapon. That's all I use this for, is to start the game. I'm not gonna get sorceries, so I don't need that. I can buy those items. Don't need the club, because I'm gonna get the occult one. Don't need the bow. Just have a crossbow. I don't think I'll use this for anything. I could use it against Quaylag. I do like chainmail just because it's lighter than plate. look at here. 800, 75, 2,000, 1,500, 2,000. I think I have just enough for the entire chain mail set. I do. Nice.
Thank you kindly.
Let's see. Let me see how good this is. Check. Okay. So 4.2. So yeah, I do lose a little bit of everything except for bleed. Has a really high bleed. Wow, so actually this is heavier than this. Only difference is bleed, poison, and magic defense. Keep this then. There we go. It's nice and light. Until we can get some more endurance so we can roll like that in our plate. You know. Let's make our dash to the Taurus Demon. How about you? Oh. I thought that was gonna kill him one hit. And I know there's a wooden shield behind that door, but my shield's much better. My first playthrough ever in Dark Souls, I actually didn't even go in there. So, this is kind of funny. I never even knew there was a guy there until, I think, my fourth playthrough. Oh, alright, these guys. This armor. There you go. Fireball. Question is, what does more damage? My Historic Straight Sword or my broadsword with gold pine resin on it? That's the real question. For the Taurus Demon. I think I'll do better with the pine resin. With pine resin and my broadsword than I will with the Historic Straight Sword. Oh. I guess I should start asking for more things. I know. Could I get $1 million to just fall in my lap right now? $1 million. Oh. Well, it was worth a try. So that's pretty awesome. And tight knights? Oh, I can even upgrade this thing a couple times too. That's awesome. Alright, so my question is, which one's better, the longsword or the broadsword? Broadsword does more damage, actually. Doesn't have the same moveset, though. It's 80 plus 9, so that's 89, that's 92. Okay. I'm curious to see which one out-levels the other, the broadsword or the longsword. I guess I still prefer the longsword's moveset. I mean, just my preference, but in this battle against the Taurus Demon, all we really need are long sweeping attacks anyways, so the broadsword will do just fine in this instance. By the way, you'll notice I like to pick up a lot of different weapons, and that's because each weapon, I like using different weapons for their most advantage. Like, you'll see me picking up the halberd here soon. When are you gonna? There you go. Tactic. I don't care if it's cheap. It's something I'll never stop doing against that boss. I mean, unless I'm doing the deprived. If you're doing the deprived, you have to fight that battle differently. Just because I don't think the club does a very good job with being able to hit as many times. I mean, I think it's still better to use pine resin on it, but you can't just slash at him like a maniac like I just did with the gold pine resin, just because the club takes way too long to reset.
I am so. Now that I am up, you stop. Find that. No need to hide your reaction. Oh, I have a solution.
Solar.
The way I see it, in a land brimming with hollows, could that really be mere chance? It pleases me greatly. We are amidst strange beings in a strange land. The flow of time itself is convoluted, with heroes centuries old phasing in and out. The very fabric wavers, and relations shift and obscure. There's no telling how much longer your world and mine will remain in contact. But use this to summon one another as spirits, and engage in jolly cooperation. Of course, we are not the only ones engaged in this, but I am a warrior of... If you miss it, you must be blind.
He'll breathe fire on me. He never does. But he didn't, never does when you're running across it. And as most people know. I always wait till the day where it's just like, the dragon's like, nope, I'm not gonna let you cross this time. Guys. Oh. I was wondering why I was taking so many hits to kill these guys. I was like, this doesn't seem right. Did they get a buff or something?
Then go ahead, never have.
There you go. You don't need anything else.
Thank you.
Alright. Well, this video is long enough. So, when we come back, we will try and make our ways to the Gargoyles, or Bell Tower. Alright, this is Cludd signing off, saying adios!